Now he worked at Robison Tech in the student financial aid office. As he drove to the campus, a collection of modern brown brick buildings in a greensward along Interstate 95, Ronnie was looking forward to the day when he wouldn't have to be rushing to class by 7 each morning, when he wouldn't have to study until after midnight each night, when he could get more than a few hours sleep at a time. He could picture himself in cap and gown, striding across the stage to receive his diploma. His mother, he knew, would be in the audience. It was she, after all, who had always stressed the importance of education, who had always pushed him to study hard and make something of himself. Ronnie had only been at work a short time when the telephone rang about 2. "I'm a friend of your mother's," said a woman who didn't identify herself. "I've heard she's going to be arrested today. I thought you ought to know." Startled, Ronnie asked, "Are you sure?" "Yes, they're going to charge her with Stewart's death." "How do you know?" "I know somebody who works in the sheriff's department." Despite his shock, Ronnie hadn't been without warning that something like this could happen. Now he realized that he shouldn't have been so quick to dismiss what his mother had told him 2 days earlier. He had been visiting his in-laws Saturday morning when his mother called, nervous and upset. The police had come the evening before and asked her to go downtown with them, she told him. The first thing that popped into Ronnie's mind was that she had been writing bad checks again. She was dependent on prescription drugs, and when they ran out, she had to have them whether she had money or not. "What did they want?" he asked, though he thought he knew. "They wanted to talk about Stewart," she said, surprising him. "They said he was poisoned. They seemed to think I had something to do with it." Her words stunned Ronnie. Poisoned?